In this video, we're going to show you how to prepare a simple graph using Microsoft Excel. In this first example here, I have the number of students in each grade. This is an example of discrete data or counted data, so the appropriate graph that I should use is a bar graph. I begin by clicking on and highlighting the data, and then going to Insert. And if I want vertical bars, I can use the column function, or if I want horizontal bars, I can use the bar function. Here I'll use the column function, so I'll click on column, and then 2D column. And here we see our bar graph. Now we have to add our labels and title to our graph. To do so, I go to Layout, and then click on Axis Titles, Horizontal, Display, Below Axis. Here I will type in the appropriate label, so we'll put in Grade Level. I go back to Axis Title, click on Vertical, and then Rotated Title. Over here I can now add the appropriate label, Number of Students. Since titles need to be descriptive, I need to change this title, so I'll just double click and then retype my title name, Number of Students in Each Grade. We have only one set of data, so this figure legend can stay as is, but if you wanted to get rid of it, you can just click on it and then press Delete. In the second example, I have here a set of data looking at the temperature in Celsius at various depths in water. So because this is an example of continuous data or measured data, the appropriate graph would be a line graph or a scatter plot. I begin the same way by clicking and highlighting on the data and going to Insert and then going to Scatter. If I want to make a scatter plot, I will click on this first one here where you see the individual data points but no lines connecting them. And here it gives us a scatter plot of that data. If I'm interested in drawing a line of best fit, I can right-click the data, go to Add Trend Line, and then I can choose the appropriate trend, whether it's linear, logarithmic, or polynomial. In this case here, we'll leave it linear. I can display my regression equation and the correlation coefficient on the graph if so desired. Get rid of that. To make a line graph, again, my data is highlighted. I go to Insert, Scatter, and now this time I choose the picture icon that has the data points with lines connecting them, and here it gives me my line graph. Again, I need to add labels and correct the title, so I'll begin by going to Layout, Axis Titles, Vertical Axis Title, Rotated, and then I can put in the correct label. In this case here it will be temperature. I include the units, so that will be degrees Celsius. I go back to Axis Titles, Horizontal, Title Below, and here I'm going to put Depth, and again include my units, meters, and then correct my title. So I will click, get rid of that, and then put in a more appropriate title. The relationship between depth and temperature. You can highlight this and go into Home. You can change the font size, the color, and all that. So I'll just reduce that down. Again, I have only one set of data, so I can choose to keep the legend here. Here, I'll get rid of it. But if you have more than one set of data, then you'll need to keep the figure legend.